You are now listening to Simbang Panas Podcast.
Yo, what is up people? Selamat datang ke lagi satu episod Simbang Panas. Okay guys, podcast kita kali ini ditajakan khas dan dibawakan khas kepada anda oleh teman ejen Hartana Ace Realtors SG. Untuk masyarakat, demi masyarakat.
Jangan lupa untuk follow rakan-rakan kami di Instagram dan juga TikTok acerealtors.sg.
Mm-hmm. Jadi kalau korang nak beli rumah ke, jual rumah ke, tak payah pening-pening kepala. Korang boleh hubungi saja ejen-ejen yang bertauliah dari acerealtors.sg.
Korang juga boleh terus hubungi mereka di talian 88779923.
Apa?
88779923.
Lagi sekali?
Kau jangan macam-macam.
Kita akan jumpa korang sebentar saja nanti. Let's go.
Podcast cakap betul, tak ada soro-soro. Ini podcast cakap betul, tak ada soro-soro. Ini podcast cakap betul, tak ada soro-soro. Ini podcast cakap betul, tak ada soro-soro. Siapa-siapa boleh go, semua kita undang. Siapa berani masuk, jangan sebab temberang. Alkisah bikin panas macam goreng pisang, itu sudah terang. Panggil semua geng-geng minat turun, jom masuk gelanggang. Jom masuk studio, dah berapa banyak idol. Kita kasih sampai viral, Alkisah dapat title. Ini Simbang Panas, it's love for the week. Ini Simbang Panas, real love on the mix, boom. Simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas. Simbang, simbang panas, 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 panas.
Yo, what is up people? Nama saya Aidy Isham.
Anazia.
Liza Baliza.
Saya Fuja Zin.
And guys, dalam episod kali ni kita ada guest lagi sekali. Yeah. And guest kita ni I would say mungkin ada yang kenal, mungkin ada yang tidak. Surprisingly kita pun actually baru juga kenal diorang lah. Yeah. From one of the events that kita punya team actually went to. Which is yang Pod Connect tu. And we met two of them. Tapi kita tak sempat berbual lah. Mungkin dua-dua side tengah segan.
Itulah kita nak kenal-kenal ni kan.
Itu yang kita bawa diorang datang lah. Kita nak kenal-kenal. And diorang pun podcaster juga.
Oh.
Saya podcaster juga. Oh. Dan podcast diorang meletup juga.
Oh.
Tapi hari ni kita cuma ada, diorang total ada 5 orang.
Betul.
Kita cuma bawa masuk 3.
Oh.
Dan kenapa sebenarnya kita was surprised lah that kita dapat tahu yang kita ada guest diorang hari ni.
Okay.
Pasal kita last minute diberitahu, tapi mu ada sebab lah yang yang menjemput diorang datang kemari adalah Liz. Dan dengannya desas desus lah, so Liz mati-mati tau nak panggil diorang juga. Dan also dalam diorang ni rajin tau buat live dekat TikTok and everything, so Liz selalu dekat dalam. And kita dapat tahulah desas desus. Okay. Ada Liz yang berbinat dengan either one of them. Jadi tanpa berbuang masa lagi, they also known as the cosplay podcast. Dan diorang punya genre macam more to kelakar seram.
Cosplay?
Agak-agak siapa? Agak-agak mana satu antara 5 yang Liz berminat?
Yang cosplay punya.
Yang cosplay punya.
Dah mengucap guys.
Nak tahu semua, kita bersama dengan KYL Podcast.
What's up?
Okay, jadi mana satu korang yang least minat?
Sabar, korang tak mau fitnah bulan Ramadan. Kau nak kena.
Dah buka. Jadi mana satu list? Ya, adakah di sini ataupun lagi dua yang
tadi? None of the five. Nanti kasi drop the hints.
Dia list pemalu orang dia. Dia mungkin bila kita recording dia malu. Dia segan nak bilang. Nanti kita dapat korek lah. Halfway through the
conversation. Every single time guys. Every single time. Aku kena bahan lagi.
Okay, by the way, welcome guys. Welcome on board.
Thank you so much.
Introduce lah diri sikit.
Okay, nama saya Danish Karl.
Okay, nama saya Nabil.
Okay, what's good? Nama saya Haikal.
Charlie Angel.
Yeah.
Okay, so sorry, Danish.
Danish.
Nabil and Haikal.
Alright.
Mana KYL ni? What does it stand for actually?
Dia stand for Hayal. Tahu tak Hayal?
Hayal spell dengan H.
K-H-A-Y-L.
Okay.
Hayal.
Mak, terserempak bodoh aku.
Habis tu punya H mana?
Dia punya K silent.
No. Yeah. Because dia orang cakap come from Hayal kan. K-H-A-Y-L. Tapi dia orang K-Y-L. H dia mana?
Tak ada kira macam nak short form lah. Tiga apa ni?
Akronim gitu. K-Y-L.
Kita punya akronim
lah. Kalau K-H-Y-L macam tak style lah.
Ya. Dia pun suka lah podcast dia. Kenapa?
Nanti K-H-Y-L jadi kill.
Boleh.
Betul kata kau Saiful.
Jadi K-Hill.
Okay, so tell us more about
kita,
apa ni?
We are 5 members. Kan kita dulu kan, kita suka main game. So kita main game, selalu kita main game kita hayal.
Okay.
Kita macam tengok game tu, kita macam hayal je. So kita macam, why not kita buka podcast namakan Hayal?
Dari game lah.
Habis
game apa tu sampai Hayal kita?
Korang main game tak korang?
Main.
Valorant, main tak?
Oh, Valorant.
Tahu tak?
Game budak-budak sekarang. Yes.
Yeah.
Tak main. Abang main CS dulu.
CS. So, dulu kita pun main CS juga. Ya.
Customer service. Gasak kau lah, Liz.
Counter-Strike lah.
Fuh, kau anak tahu. Ex-polis suka main game tembak-tembak.
Oh, dia polis.
Ex-polis.
Dulu dia main training tembak orang pakai Counter-Strike dulu.
Lepas tu baru.
Kisah dia Al-Kisah.
Okay, so sorry, pasal yang korang punya podcast. How long have korang been
first January 2024 kita debut.
Okay.
Debut.
Korang ni kasih lagi sebab bual.
Kita debut on first
least,
January 2024.
Aku tahu kau excited.
Aku tahu kau excited. Tak asal. Kau pun sama apa?
Liz, kau ni tangan macam gegar.
Adakah dah
join? Diorang dah join sama-sama.
Sorry, sebelum kita start, korang ada yang ada girlfriend, dah kahwin, ada tunang?
Ada, aku.
Oh, Haikal seorang. Okay.
Tunang lagi 2 minggu.
Congratulations. Shali, sudah. Dia dah tak boleh.
Apa aku? Kali bukan dia.
Okay, next.
Dahlah, aku diam je lah.
Dah ada mata air.
Baru dilepaskan.
Betul.
Mungkin lah, ni kita jadi episod mencari jodoh untuk Liz. Cari jodoh untuk Zah, kita ada cari jodoh lagi.
Dah ada segmen.
Baru kita berbual pasal kita nak kena ada segmen baru.
Okay.
Adalah finally.
Saya tak ada.
Tak ada
single. Saya
okay.
Single.
Jadi,
tapi looking tak?
Tak lah. Okay. Masih sekolah.
Memang suka sekolahkan budak-budak.
Oh, iya ke?
Boleh
cuba. Boleh cuba, ya?
Sabar. Buat
tadi apa soalan aku? Okay. By the way, kita punya podcast hari ni dengan KYL. It's gonna be... if you guys are expecting something, okay, kita just gotta lay it down. It's just a salam perkenalan.
Betul.
Antara. Because we're trying to have a segment where kita bring in other podcasters into kita punya apa ni podcast to share lah. Because I feel macam honestly there isn't much interaction between the podcasters in this industry, and kalau ada pun.
Kita interact kat TikTok je.
And it's just there. You know, you don't get to meet people. And we are always enclosed, like within the four of us. Kurang five of you guys. You know, jarang kita dapat berbual. So kita nak sharing lah pasal korang ni podcast pula.
Aku memang nak jumpa list ni actually.
Kau tak mau.
Ada motif lah ni sebenarnya.
Ada lah.
Guys, this will be fine.
Aku tak masukkan lagu seksi.
Guys, this will be my last podcast. I have resigned from this.
Yelah, pasal kau nak pergi KYL.
Now kita tahu. You jumping ship.
Sejukkan aircon.
Panas.
Aku penat.
Saya gurau saja.
Tak apa, it's okay.
Tak apa,
Dah cukup korang dah. Korang pun dah cukup.
Okay, kita kasi Liz pula berbual lah.
Apa yang kau nak tahu? Pasal kau memang nak kena interview jodoh kau. Bakal. Interview je, bakal.
Whatever lah. Okay, I want to ask korang like, kenapa korang decide to do a cosplay podcast? Because I think the only other podcast that pernah buat cosplay was, correct me if I'm wrong, is Okay Let's Go, but it's not macam a fix. But korang is fixed, right?
Sila Haikal jawabkan.
Haikal buka sikit lah cerita dia.
Actually memang kita started with the whole intention nak go with horror punya concept lah.
Okay.
Yeah, tapi at the same time pun kita nak versatile. That's why kita got different kind. Ada macam sedih, ada happy, ada seram. Nah, tapi kalau kita nak buat seram, banyak podcasters kat luar semua dah buat horror seram pun.
Okay.
So kita tengah fikir macam mana nak jadi different sikit lah. Then from there tu kita like, eh, why not kita dress up? Kita kasih kau-kau lah, makeup semua form.
Jadi buat sendiri? All that thing is
buat sendiri. Makeup semua sendiri je. Then from there, kita selalu macam, eh, ni macam not bad lah. Macam orang pun ada minta-minta balik. So kita pun, no, let's go for second one, then go for the third one.
Betul.
Tapi kenapa korang pakai tissue paper?
Okay. Pasal kita nak jadi unik. Takkan nak beli kain kafan kan, Liz?
Belum apa-apa dah kena.
Kau nak kita mati ke?
So the interesting thing is, untuk korang-korang yang belum lagi tengok ataupun tak pernah come by diorang punya content dekat TikTok especially. So diorang diorang punya cosplay ni bukan macam yang kita cakap pasal jumpa kat Suntec punya kind of cosplay atau macam anime high-end cosplay. Dia bukan.
Very true.
Dia cosplay asal boleh.
I would say macam asal boleh, low budget kind of cosplay.
Apa yang bikin
with everything that you guys can find.
Yes. Betul-betul.
So that includes macam Liz cakap tadi lah, tissue paper. Plastik bag hitam.
Betul.
Apa lagi yang korang pernah pakai?
Okay, aku punya cosplay aku jadi pocong tu kan. Aku pakai selimut tau.
Selimut?
Tak. Kau pakai sarung bantal.
Sarung bantal. So aku pakai je lah, jadi macam durag.
Macam mana kau sarung bantal?
Durag.
Salah dengar.
Sarung kepala.
Durag ya.
Tawa lah sebab.
Itu kendal sikit.
Bukan.
Janji boleh muat.
Habis makeup korang, korang pakai apa?
Apa dia?
Makeup korang pakai
makeup
apa?
Makeup pakai apa eh?
Makeup kita pakai white male face paint dengan basically kita pakai mata aku punya barang-barang lah. Kita beli like depe white face paint, tapi depe untuk mata semua barang dia lah.
Okay.
Dia tacak-tacakkan untuk kita.
Okay, interesting. Bila kau nak pakai tissue paper lah?
Sudah tak payah.
Kalau kau pakai durek tu, kepala lagi satu je boleh masuk.
Dah cukup.
Kepala tut.
We know where that was going, right?
Okay. I want to ask, like, how did you guys conceptualize this to becoming a podcast, and what was the challenges korang face, like, in order to start this podcast and to create this idea?
Okay, I think kalau nak start berbual pasal how the beginning of us being introduced in the podcast industry, it's more to Sufi and Danish lah. So I will let them do the talking lah. Okay, so sebelum kau continue, satu soalan kita tak tanya. Actually korang apa, kawan dari janggut ke adik-beradik ke saudara mara ke?
Nabil ni, Nabil dengan Haikal dong adik-beradik.
Boleh nampak.
Tapi saya dengan Nabil, dengan saya aku Nabil dengan Haikal saudara.
Okay, so adik-beradik, saudara.
Lagi dua?
Yang Sufi tu abang saya.
Dua adik-beradik.
So yang luar, yang Syafiq tu dia kawan.
Kawan
secondary school.
Ada one pair dan kawan lah.
Dia anak kutip lah gitu.
Tak lah.
Tak ada lah.
Bukan
kira family jugalah.
Family jugalah.
Basically, the whole idea is kita nak buat macam more a family cozy punya community. That's why kita punya
itu jawapannya
kat dalam. So even pasal kita semua dah saudara apa, so kita nak tunjuk macam, oh, even ada kawan pun boleh vibe dengan kita. Even dalam community kita kita boleh not just vibe along kita, masuk live kita boleh like, dah macam dah kenal lama lah.
Ada ni tak, since korang dua beradik and anyway, lepas tu korang empat saudara, and then he's the only one, macam the only odd one out. Ada tak macam difficulty ke dia pernah share dengan korang,
tak,
macam
pasal
dia susah ke?
Kita kenal Ahmad Syafiq dari lama, sejak dia secondary school pun. So bila kita lepak
macam adik-beradik lah.
Kita lepak, kita bercycling, kita
main bola
semua-sama. So tak ada macam rasa awkward lah.
Okay. So you guys grew up together lah.
Grew up together.
Korang punya age group semua about the same?
About the same.
20s. Umur berapa by the way?
28.
Muka ini
macam mana tu guys?
Sabar. Okay, Nabil? Aku umur 25 lah. Kita nampak muda je.
Kan.
Muka ini.
Aika?
Aku pula 28. 28.
Muka ini just
yeah. Kenapa? Kenapa?
Yang lagi dua?
Lagi dua, lagi satu is 25 so right?
Yes.
Habis Sufi 30.
Sama dengan kau Adi.
Takde apa yang aku mati-mati ingat all this while diorang macam age budak-budak lipat je lah.
Yeah, yeah, kan?
Like belasan at most pun 22, 23. Pak mana saya 28?
Sana so, kita cakap lah.
Maybe pasal kita shave lah.
Ya, kita shave.
God's blessing lah.
Ya, Alhamdulillah kan.
Aku sama.
Ya. Kita banyak tidur lah. Banyak tidur.
Itu rezeki kau dah macam gitu.
Banyak tidur.
Banyak tidur.
Bukan banyak tidur. Bukan banyak tidur. Banyak hayal.
Banyak hayal. Saya pun kat
sini. Okay, okay, okay.
Okay, boleh. Jadi balik kepada soalan ni. Okay.
Apa soalan ni?
Yeah, how did you guys conceptualize that into reality, into podcast, and apa korang punya biggest challenge when wanting to start this podcast?
Chimnya.
Apa dia?
Chims ya.
Chim sangat.
Okay, basically,
one part first lah.
Okay,
what's the difficulty bila kita nak
challenge
start, yalah, start up podcast lah.
Timing management juga. Pasal kita semua dah kerja. Habis masing-masing kerja, timing lari.
Okay.
Kan? So,
lari. Kau siap eh?
Dah lama aku tak dapat orang pilih R tau.
Lama
sekali.
Kan?
Dah lama eh?
Dah lama.
Lama.
Ambil Liza apa Liza?
Liz punya tak macam menonjol sangat.
Yeah, yeah,
okay. Okay, okay. It's not obvious. So aku punya obvious.
Jadi macam judul eh? Sama-sama pilih R.
He was waiting for that.
Macam mana
that
kita nak mengaji ni?
Roh jangan sebut.
Guys, okay, aku dah give up tau. Sikit-sikit aku kena kat anak
aku
help.
Tau, dia sebelah aku je tau.
Itulah, itulah.
The best part, orang join this tau. I have nobody on my side. Guys, help.
Aku actually notice bila dia buat TikTok kat Al-Kisan Production, dia berbual pasal news-new tu semua ni. Aku dah notice. First sentence aku dah tahu, dia mesti pilih R. Aku tak cakap hi tak apa. Aku macam, ni list yang pilih R kan?
Ya, dan mesti aku cakap hi. Cakap, ni list yang pilih R. Aku cakap,
tengok macam
secucuk kau siap. Tak boleh, tak boleh.
Nampaknya ada yang geng-geng dia pun tengah join kita ni.
Ada yang setuju tu.
Merapakan silaturahim.
Aku penat lah guys.
Penat.
Okay, so other than that was your...
Tadi dia stop kat mana?
Tak, kita biggest challenge is time management lah.
Time management.
Pasal nak buat every weekend week out lah. Macam kadang-kadang dia punya schedule lain, dia schedule lain. Habis kita buat content, kena cosplay, kena make up. Kan.
Why are you guys working as by the way?
Saya student lagi. Saya buat freelance videography lah.
Okay.
Student kat mana?
Student kat mana?
Student kat mana?
PSB Academy.
PSB.
Ya. Dekat dengan Uni Mati lah. Okay, situ kan. Aku actually pernah nampak korang tau. Aku mak alamak tak bisa kat tempat makan lah. Aku kat alamak.
Itu kau seorang.
Tak, aku nampak korang rumah. Tapi time tu aku belum
buka-buka masuk Shake Shack.
Tak, aku kan office korang kat lift dekat
mereka.
Saya pas by situ nak cuci tangan je.
Oh shit.
Oh dear.
Shit.
Apa dia jadi?
No, now you like give me a flashback.
Flashback
that
kan?
Yeah, flashback. Okay. Macam aku pernah nampak kau.
Pernah. Kita pernah semua pernah eye contact. Tapi tak kaya. Pasal aku siapa kan?
Oh.
Panas.
Yeah. Betul lah. Itu produk semua practice eh? Sama ada sponsor
dia. Dia dah warm up guys.
Pelan-pelan dia kasi keluar.
Dia dah buka.
So student buat part time videography.
Okay.
Untuk
wedding, untuk podcast pun boleh buat.
Nampak dia tengah push je.
Tapi tak boleh. Korang ada sponsor kan.
Betul lah. Tapi kita tengah cari lah videographer. Sebab tu Liz panggil dia.
It's not more than love lah.
Kalau couple, couple Liz tak payah bayar. Tak
payah bayar. Kira
free labor. Kau tengok muka dia terus seng-seng dan reject kau Liz.
Korang mempergunakan aku akhirnya.
So Liz suka aku?
Itu nampaknya dia.
Liz suka Danish KY. Title.
Tak ada. The thing is, before this podcast, aku suruh diorang standby. Cakap kita will bully diorang. Aku rasa yang kena. Aku yang kena tau.
Plot twist.
Sure diorang standby. Aku baru realize sekarang. Sure, standby.
Kau dah kenal aku berapa lama, Saiful?
The fact that he mentioned it, I'm like, oh, yeah.
Bila orang nervous, dia makin menonjol. Pilar R dia tu.
Okay lah, cukup lah. Thank you, Kak Anda lah.
Okay, so why are you working as? Oh my God.
So aku actually, aku study under macam hotel line lah.
Okay.
Hotel line. So macam kita buat hotel and buat F&B jugalah. So,
hospitality ya?
Yes, hospitality line. Hmm. So sekarang ni aku kerja under F&B lah. So one of the restaurants dalam Paya Lebar lah. Itu kisah
hotel
dia.
Kat Paya Lebar ke?
Bukan restoran bang. Restoran.
Oh, restoran je.
Restoran je.
Okay.
Itulah kisah dia. So Haikal pula?
Aku kerja educator lah. Ajar budak-budak primary school lah.
Dia cikgu tau.
Kau cikgu?
Ya. So, ya, ya.
Ex-teacher?
Tak boleh match saya dengan muka.
Yeah. Kau ajar apa? Like dekat primary school?
Primary school. Tapi more towards, tak, bukan subject tapi more to character development. So confidence building, self-esteem.
CCE lessons eh?
Tak, dia macam like after school punya.
Macam vendor gitulah.
Ya, macam vendor gitu.
Okay. Dia ada tu?
Dia ada tu, Fee dengan Nish is doing the same thing lah.
Ya, yeah. So Fee kerja video editing juga.
Ada lagi satu. Okay.
Ada, ya. Yeah.
Then Ahmad dengan Bill kerja sama-sama. Diorang tak boleh pisah lah diorang.
Tak boleh pisah bro.
Okay. Sebab tu, actually satu boleh datang kan, satu tak boleh. So, tapi dua-dua tak atas. Dah biasa. Salah lagu.
Okay, moving on. Sorry.
By the way, heard korang ada your own media punya company.
Ya, DKSK Diaries. Ni saya dengan Sufi, kita buat, kita open a business videography punya company. Ya, itulah.
Bilang sikit, promo sikit company tu.
Tak, pasal kita baru start juga. So kita buat videography for wedding. Last 2 days kita baru upload a proposal video.
Okay.
Kita buat untuk Taylor Swift punya concert. After concert kita buat macam proposal video lah. Yeah, so do check it out, DKSK Diaries. That's good.
DKSK Diaries?
DKSK Diaries. Danishkal Sufikal Diaries.
Ni adik-beradik ni bisnes.
Adik-beradik punya.
That's cool. Korang adik-beradik tak ada bisnes?
Tak ada bisnes.
InsyaAllah diorang akan ada juga.
InsyaAllah.
Ada restoran kat sekolah?
Idea. Buat jualan
Kau nak buat macam macam ni. Buat jualan.
Okay. Moving on. I know that korang pernah viral because of this one video, but it was taken down. Can you all explain?
What
the video is about and why it got taken down?
Okay, so basically the video tu is more of macam a harmless punya memory regarding secondary school days lah.
Okay.
Tapi I guess in the standpoint view of macam the affected person. Macam is ibaratkan macam buka aib dia lah.
Okay.
Tapi the response we got from our viewers and the comments tu semua is a very positive feedback tu semua lah. Because macam is something people would relate that kind of thing. But so dia, the person that was affected tu, dia macam dia tak feel good about it lah. I guess dia cakap macam it affected his moral kat kerja ni semua kan.
Okay.
So at that point of time kita pun macam okay lah, never mind lah. Since this is a first time jugalah macam sort of macam kita buat ni kan. So we decided to take it down. So macam insyaAllah tak affect anything anymore lah kan.
But pasal CD tu dia tengah kerja lagi. So kita tak nak affect dia punya career lah.
So what was the memory about?
Sebab aku nak kena recap juga sah.
Dia pasal the big class.
One of korang make guess lah kira.
Tak,
kita ceritakan pengalaman dia during secondary school.
Yeah. Macam kita berbual pasal vitrun eh. Tapi lepas tu
vitrun stress.
Vitrun turun kan.
Sebab kita pok nama lah. So but we thought it was harmless lah at that time lah kan. But apparently it got affected to him. Then dia punya people around him got connected to us lah. Then cakap tak boleh buat ni semua. Kau berlain bla bla bla. Then okay lah, takpelah, kita just take it down lah.
But how bad was the actions that he did?
I don't see.
Or is it just a harmless whatever we always do during secondary school kind
dia
of
macam,
thing?
Dia macam, the cikgu dia macam more vocal lah. So aku rasa maybe aib dia. Pasal dia masih tengah mengajar kan.
Oh, macam
so,
cikgu Rohaizah.
Tegur lah gitu.
Cikgu Rohaizah.
Kenapa ni?
Tak dengar podcast.
Stay tuned to the next episode.
Okay, since korang semua macam kerja lain-lain, how do you guys actually find the time untuk come together to record podcast? Like manage korang punya time lah basically.
Okay, I would say because Haikal ni dia kerja is more to Monday to Friday lah. So at any point of time, usually it will be weekend lah. Dia akan free kan. So maybe Friday night lepas kerja. So for me dengan Ahmad, kita punya schedule kita tak fix. So it's more of
FMB
of, yeah, kita FMB. So kita more of a, kita nak kena learn. Kita bopian lah. Sacrifice lah. Sacrifice. Cause nak grind this kind of thing kan. So kita just, whoever kerja next day sebab je. Kita just wait. Yeah, macam our latest episode kita habis like 5 a.m. 5, 6 a.m.
Yeah. Yeah. Then next day kena kerja.
Next day kau 10 dah nak kena keluar pergi kerja. Dia kata, so tak apalah, kita wait je lah. Demi content.
But korang make it like fix lah. Every Friday night, confirm turun record.
Tak, kena tiga macam tu. Kadang-kadang, could be Monday night. Ikut Nabi dengan Abok punya schedule lah. Pasal me dengan Sufi, okay je. Pasal shoot kat rumah kita. Kita studio in our house. Then kita boleh shoot kat rumah Nabi juga. So, yalah.
Oh, diorang macam lepak je lah. Saya shoot kat rumah semua.
Lepak je lah. Aku nampak first episode lepak je lah diorang kat rumah. Kat balcony kan.
Kira jiran korang lepak eh? Tak ada yang komplain ke? Memang korang rekod tak selalu bising?
Kita bising jugalah. Tapi bising juga. Tapi kita tutup tingkap, tutup pintu. So,
Tapi korang tak terkejut lah. Dah malam pukul 5 habis ada pocong sebelah korang ke apa.
Ada pocong.
Oh ya. Korang buat podcast cosplay. And most of the time korang cosplay sebagai hantu kan. Tak pernah kena kacau ke apa.
Cerita-cerita.
Go there.
Oh, banyak lah pengalaman ni.
Banyak.
Recording pun ada. Let's go.
Kat rumah padahal
Actually ni punya ringkas je. So there was one period kita buat outdoor main shoot. Kita buat outdoor main shoot. Initially kita nak shoot dengan video. Tapi on that day video buat hal. So tiba macam tak boleh record more than what, 10 minutes je. Tak boleh record more than 10 minutes. 10 minit mati.
Camera tau, camera.
Padahal dah prep semua and all. So kita pun just carry on je lah. So kita end up doing like audio punya shoot. So kita tengah berbual-bual. Then at that point of time, Bill tengah buka cerita. So kita pun tengah layan dia bercerita. Then tiba-tiba dia pause. Dia pause habis dia tengok muka kita. So kita have this thing where like macam, okay kalau satu orang dah tangkap benda kan, kita dah boleh baca lah. So at that point of time, bila Bill dah pause habis dia tengok kita, so kita pun macam, okay takpe, sambung, carry on. So kita carry on. Then lepas habis shoot, then kita dah go away from that place. Dan tu kita tanya Bill lah macam, ya asal tadi kau pause like awkwardly kan. So dia cakap aku, pasal okay kita punya setting okay korang just imagine macam sama setting macam gini. Outdoor tapi belakang macam abandoned house.
Abandoned house kat mana ni korang pergi?
Nak boleh cakap?
Boleh. Ini bukan KC.
Selita.
Aku tahu KC tak kasi.
Selita. Selita.
Selita.
Aerospace.
Oh, aerospace.
Okay. Ada abandoned house ke situ?
Ada.
Ada.
Kita nak cari tempat swi-swi mah.
Okay.
Okay, so terus kita tanya Bill. Habis belum cakap. Bila dengar cerita tu, pasal belakang dia is facing the abandoned building tu.
Okay.
So dia cakap the reason why dia pause, pasal bila dia tengah berbual, dia dengar ada bunyi orang tumpang ketawa kat belakang dalam tu building.
So, time korang tengah ketawa sekali.
Kita tak really ketawa. Kita macam tengah tengah tanya Bill lah.
Having a conversation.
Oh shit.
Terus Bill dengar macam ada orang like ketawa. So kita tahu okay that's it lah. Dapat tangkap masuk tu episode.
Okay. So basically the thing is bila kita tengah ceritakan lah. So basically we doing our storytelling. At that point of time tu, on my right side was the abandoned building lah. So aku terdengar suara jantan ketawa lah.
Suara jantan.
So okay, so aku just brush aside. Then the thing is, kat episode kita bila keluar, bunyi perempuan ketawa.
Really macam gitu lah.
Especially korang semua lelaki kan. So dengar suara perempuan, it's
Weird.
Yeah, it couldn't be anybody else.
Dalam this setting tu, kau dekat sebelah mana? Ujung? Ke kau kat tengah?
Bill kat tengah lah.
Bill kat tengah.
Aku facing.
Yang lain tak dengar?
Dia semua tak dengar.
Chosen one.
Yeah.
But in the recording can be heard.
Can be heard. This just to sum up is kakak ketawa dengan kita lah.
Okay.
Loud and clear in the recording.
Dia tengah enjoying the podcast lah.
Sekali ya.
Aku rasa kita kelakar sangat lah.
Dia tamu, jadi dia enjoy.
Kelakar serap kan?
Kelakarnya podcast.
Seram saya the way even
I. Kau jangan.
Kau jangan, nanti aku yang kena stay sini tau malam.
Okay, okay. And that one was pukul berapa agak-agak?
Eh, tapi tu baru
2 pagi.
Dua pagi.
Ah, yeah.
Oh, dah pukul 3. Lah.
Yeah.
Actually, ada few time jugalah bila kita, every time kita dress up, ada dapat follow up dia lah.
Oh, okay. Next story, silakan.
Okay. Next story kat rumah aku. Bila kita tengah record, aku ni part nak ceritakan lah. So, bila aku dah cerita-cerita, aku don't know what's the topic about. Aku ceritakan, terus aku dengar macam ada orang...
Eh, sialah.
Macam like jenis, macam like geram lah macam.
Okay.
Tapi aku tengok semua, eh, semua tak cakap apa-apa.
Yeah.
Dia kat belakang aku, dekat balcony aku lah.
Yeah.
What, you mean you saw atau?
Tak dengar.
Dengar.
Dekat telinga.
Because when you, kau dengar record podcast kan, kalau kau dengar satu orang macam, kau pause pun. Takkan kau continue. So aku macam, eh, siapa tu? And dalam video tu aku cakap, eh, siapa tu?
Ada tegur lah.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
Macam terlalu unexpected. Kau takkan expect pun. Macam is another
party. Because you thought it is someone tengah pick out lah.
Was that one also caught on? Boleh dengar?
Ah, tu tak dengar.
Tak dengar. Ni kat rumah aku lah.
Tapi after that, follow up tak ada, tak ada benda lah. Oh, macam
je.
Ada lah. Ada kat rumah aku lah.
Nampak lah?
Bukan nampak.
Kedengaran.
Yeah.
Kedengaran.
Kacau. Only you heard or your whole family also hear?
My whole family yang kak Mi and Sufi tinggal tu. Dengar.
Semua dengar?
Dengar.
Oh, shit.
Pasal rumah aku ni tangga, ada orang macam mengilai lah.
Kira dah expose
Kau tinggal cakap location mana.
Kau tinggal tingkat berapa? Tu aku nak tahu.
3-3. Okay, just kena biar rumah aku masinet.
Okay.
So, rumah aku tangga sebelah lift. Rumah aku sebelah lift.
Okay.
So opposite lift ada macam tangga tu turun level 1. So abang aku Sufi cakap selalu bila dia tidur, dia dengar macam ada perempuan macam
Menangis
kat tangga. Like asking for help lah. Macam like tengah pas lah. So tapi kita think positively lah. Okay, maybe perempuan tengah going through backup ke.
Abang kau lah.
Abang
kau sekarang dah dua orang? Dah ada empunya badan?
Dia tarik balik.
Single. Dah ada partner ke? Single lagi.
Dah berpunya ke tak?
Itu sebenarnya Liz. Liz yang nangis.
Nanti saya sampaikan ke Liz Baliza.
Kalau kau nak tahu dulu, dari dulu Liz tengah kejar abang kau.
Berapa lama tu?
Berapa lama yang kau dengar dia nangis? Dia sebenarnya.
Every week.
Lepas tu dah sampai after a while, terus dah tak dengar lagi kan?
Tak.
Pasal dia tengah nak kejar kau pula.
Patutlah aku gila dia selalu online.
Dia tunggu. Every time dia tengok, kurang live je. Terus dia pergi.
Korang selalu live pukul berapa?
Aku 2 sampai sahur lah.
Sebab tu kau 2 sampai sahur, kita call dia tak live. Kerja semua terbengkalai kan?
So dia kat tepi tangga tengah join live ni?
Dia
join
live tu.
Pasal kita mesej macam, dia ni tak reply.
Ni kerja ke tak ni?
Lain kali cuba jenguk. Tengok ada tak?
Lain kali tengok lah.
Tak payah jenguk, tengok lampu mewah je dah tahu lah.
Sekali jadi cikgu. Yang best part kan, Liz punya reply will be, aku nak D&D sekejap.
Jadi
D&D.
Oh, D&D.
D&D.
Abang kau nama apa?
Sufi.
Apa-apa lagi kau
tak? Aku ingat Danish and Daniel ke apa?
Tak lah.
Daniel mana pula kau?
Aduh.
Ya, dah habis.
Tapi bual pasal diorang punya apa ni cerita ni. Kau ingat tak yang kita punya tempat lama?
Kau ceritakan pula lah.
Which one?
Oh, which one?
Sila lanjutkan. Yeah, we got 2 places S-O-P. Yang...
Okay.
Lanjut.
So, kisah ni bermula tahun bila ni?
Actually, 3. The first place was yang dekat Sunview.
Oh, kau put nama. Okay, Sunview.
Sunview, memang dulu kita kat sana. Yeah, so kita tengah record sama juga.
Okay.
Tengah record. And that time, kita ada...
Guest.
Kawan aku. Yang dia pun buat property. Dia famous pasal macam buat citan tu lah.
Okay.
So, kita buat nak masuk. Tengah record... And that time kira cerita tu. So lampu semua kita off just to get the feel lah.
Oh, yeah,
tengah bawa. Tak tu apa yang off dulu?
The roadcaster tiba-tiba bunyi high pitch.
Dia macam macam eh ya. Ah dia eh ah. Oh buat
yeah,
suara-suara hilang.
Ada gangguan lah.
Dia macam like fucking loud tau. Dia senyap gitu. So kita dah macam asal eh. Habis lepas tu benda semua jam. Kau pecik apa butang tak boleh gerak. Kau nak apa, aku nak try off pun tak boleh.
Alamak,
bulu roma semua dah diri. Kita dah ada macam wah fuck eh. Lepas tu kita turun bawah.
Okay.
And then kita sakuk je. Naik balik.
Still jam.
So kita off plug apa gini semua tu kita cakap. Kita
but the funny thing is bila kita off plug, the roadcaster was still light up.
Yeah, it was creepy as hell.
Dia nak join podcast sangat dia tak?
Mungkin maybe dia nak join. Mungkin
ada chance lah tu nak jadi guest.
That was the first one. The second one was
no, then after that, the next day kita check, the clip was gone.
Oh yeah, yeah.
The clip was gone.
The audio recording was gone.
Waduh,
itu berat tu.
Yeah, and the record like almost done tu. The episode.
Last story.
Last story. So it was about like dah 45 minit.
Okay.
Tu hilang. Kira hantu bastard lah. Tak gentle lah. Dia kalau kasi hilang 10 minit tak pedih sangat. So that was one. The second one aku rasa yang dekat tempat sekolah tu lah.
Ananda
sekolah.
Sekolah. So for a while kita sebelum dapat tempat ni, our friend let us use sekolah lah.
A preschool basically.
Tempat dia I would say quite creepy.
Yeah.
Pasal dia one, it was dekat Pasir Ris.
Yeah.
And right beside the Pasir Ris Park.
Correct.
Tu satu. So it was just a preschool there. Habis bila kita datang, kau tahu standard preschool semua dah tutup ke?
Yeah.
And the whole building was already dark. So bila kita masuk, every time macam you know just school punya atmosphere. Especially it's preschool.
Yeah.
And then bilik banyak-banyak semua gelap kan. So every time we come, we already have macam that feeling kan. You know like someone's watching you kind of thing. But we just brush it off. Pasal lagi pun kita tak ada tempat. Dah bopian. So kita record kat sana. Then there was a few time we feel, but kita tak nampak apa-apa.
Belum
nampak.
Korang lah actually. Aku tak.
Yes. Aku dengan this is was after Ferd punya Rukiam punya case.
Yes. Yang Ferd kena kacau.
Before that right, there was nothing. It's just feeling aja. Then after he cerita his Rukiam punya case, then he disappeared for a while. Then when he came back right, got two times kita kena kacau. Two times. So the first time was kitorang tengah buat podcast, then kitorang macam rasa like something
pass by.
Macam ada benda like with us, you know. So kitorang macam apa sia ni. Then after that I think we ended the episode. Then after that ID say, okay guys, so how wanna go for another episode? Then after that I say, no, pack up right now, we're going back. After that ID cakap, serious lah? Then he cakap, yeah pack. Then after that ID look at me macam I not fucking around.
No, the thing was pasal aku pun dah rasa it's just that aku nak beranikan lah. So aku cakap, okay jom lah record lagi satu lah apa gini semua. Sai dah cakap gitu, terus aku macam okay, I know something's wrong. Then aku ask again lah macam, confirm pun tak nak record. I mean like we are here. Kita nak turun jauh-jauh. Aku dari jurung saya turun Pasir Ris just to record one episode.
Wow.
Habis aku macam sial lah, momok tak momok lah. Sial mungkin dah sial. You know,
boom.
Just the moment aku say that, I was facing that door. There was one door at the back.
Okay.
Ada orang cengok
belakang aku.
Yeah,
the one you all see belakang aku.
Correct. Yes. It was Adi cekar lah. Cekar. Pasal rambut dia panjang gila.
Yeah.
So dia macam cak terus masuk. Tak aku macam okay, back up.
Pay up.
Tak boleh je. Tak boleh.
Because the thing is, I also saw. Tapi I saw macam mata tengah merah tau. So then after that, ID told me what. He asked me, mata merah. Cakap. Habis aku macam, start dia pun nampak. So aku macam, let's go back right now. Just go back right now.
That's but then that was the only time yang kita nampak dia. After that,
aku dengan Liz kena.
Liz
remember we were walking to the apa nak?
Oh, yang air tu eh?
Ya, nak fill up demi air.
Oh, kau nampak aku tak apa-apa.
So I was walking with Liz, then suddenly Liz tengah apa ni filling up the cup noodle dengan air panas. Then after that suddenly because I facing Liz right, it's a macam a rectangular. So Liz is facing that side. So the only way to exit is behind. So I'm not looking behind me. So then suddenly I feel macam ada benda tau kat belakang. Macam like about to touch me like that, you know. Then I was like, I sit down. Aku bulu
semua. Isulah.
Lepas tu aku macam Liz cepat sikit. Dia cakap, ha Hasan cepat cepat cepat. Dah terus okay Liz macam ini. Terus aku tanya Liz, kau tengah period eh? Dia cakap,
Habis
aku macam, yeah, I get ask you, kau tengah period. Dah Liz cakap, okay, quickly take the thing, let's walk back slowly. Okay. But I want you to walk in front, I walk behind. So then after tengah jalan, then after I, one of the classrooms ada mata kat situ that I like just brush it off. I
wow.
Aku macam tak leceh.
The thing is, aku tak pernah rasa or tak pernah nampak.
Yang kau punya kau kena kacau cuma yang dia, the main air tu.
Yeah, but then aku rasa macam just the pipe not functioning or something.
Okay, okay.
Positive thinking lah.
Positive lah. Doakan yang terbaik lah.
Susah tu. Susah. Dia hantu pun kena sampai malas nak kata.
Okay.
Masalahnya, dia cakap macam ini. Tapi dia call aku dengan ID.
No, I did not call.
Apa dia?
Not call.
Dia text dia macam.
Memang takut.
Member text. Guys. Aku
am I hearing things?
Am I hearing things? So dia record, dia kasi kita dengar.
Ada apa?
Ada macam dia punya air macam tengah main-main lah.
Main jamban lah. Kira.
Dia nak berak lah tu.
Tengah beristinjak lah tu.
Tengah main sabun. So kita orang tengah macam okay, macam dengar air. I cakap, Liz, are you in that place with anybody else? She said, no, I'm alone. Okay, and it's a running water. So that means somebody had to turn it on.
Yeah.
So then after that, halfway through, she say, guys, dah tak ada, dah hilang. So apa? Orang switch off pun. Tiba. And the thing is, okay, inside my head is, they landed tau.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So that means right, there's no way for a water pipe to be running from
dari
somewhere
atas, and it was at level 2.
Yeah, it was level 2.
Yeah, tak ya.
Yeah, so then I was like, shit. Ni cerita seram tapi dengar lagu. Cerita seram.
Engkau tak cakap.
Dah kelakar seram ni.
Kita
dah habis ID.
Oh, dah.
Tak.
Cerita seram juga.
Okay,
so cakap.
Tak ada. So, ni studio ada tak?
Ni studio tak ada cerita.
Ada, takkan tak ada. Ulu macam tu.
No, only that time when aku tiba-tiba out of nowhere on live malam-malam.
Okay.
It's because I hear this.
You tengah edit ke?
Yes. Then aku dengar gini.
Siapa tu?
Okay, so
ni kat sini.
Bila tengah atas, yeah, the table was
inside. No, and it was loud. Remember when I was in the live dia aku tanya kau bunyi apa tu? No.
I don't know. People in the comments were just making fun, like macam just sengaja takutkan aku. So I thought you were joking.
No, legit. I was hearing that same voice. Kau aku tanya kau bunyi apa tu? Right?
Also you are legit. I thought you were making you were joking around.
Yeah, actually kat sini pun aku rasa ada.
Ada juga.
Yang budak-budak ni kita tengah record je gini. Budak-budak ni tegak luar. Tengah so diorang kononnya nak buat telebubble dengan each other. Diorang tengah telebubble tu bunyi orang ketuk. Duk.
Ketuk apa?
Dua kali ya? Yang duk. Diorang macam. Jadi diorang macam.
Tapi ada yang satu yang aku tak boleh lupa.
Macam apa dia?
So aku tengah recording podcast.
Okay.
Tengah recording podcast. Terus tiba-tiba
tiba.
Pintu terbuka.
Allah. Siapa keluar?
Aku dengan Liz diri situ. Pintu terbuka.
Habis?
Cepat. Situ.
Macam mana? Siapa tu?
Aku pusing. Aku cakap, Liz, don't fuck
around. It was around. Just the two of you guys, right?
Yeah. Aku cakap, Liz, don't fuck around. Aku cakap jangan main-main. Habis Liz bertangan macam ini.
Because Liz was back facing the door.
Yeah, so there was no way.
I was looking at her like that.
Then suddenly the door open very fast tau. Laju gila tau. Aku macam,
what?
Okay, jangan macam-macam saya Liz. Aku grab Liz punya tangan. Aku keluar. Habis ada momok dari bawah tangkap kaki aku.
Bodoh. Aku percaya tiang.
Oh, dia lah.
Yelah.
The thing is, guys, korang catch the story tak? Dia takut. Dia grab aku. Dia letak aku kat depan.
Yelah.
No, I walk out first. I pull you from
back.
Yelah.
Tak, kau takut kau kena grab aku.
Yelah, pasal kalau benda macam tu tak main dengan pintu, that's the best way to, that's the time when somebody telling you to fuck off, man.
Dia dah main ganas ya tu pintu.
Tak legit, laju saya aku.
Manusia lu.
Lepas aku kena maki free-free satu jam.
Free flow saya ada kena dengan aku. Semua language terkeluar saya betul-betul. Trilingual.
Tapi so far korang bahasa nampak punya tak pernah nampak ah.
6
like time korang recording ke apa?
Recording tak pernah nampak lah.
Tak pernah.
Tak pernah. Harap tak lah kan.
Mungkin lah.
Balik-balik.
I think one of the things that is always being mentioned is kalau kau dah dress up one, kira kau dah memanggil. Lepas tu pula kau berbual pasal tu. Then dia kira macam so dia macam nak join lah.
Tapi thankfully tak pernah nampak lah. Tapi it's always dia punya
rasa-rasa atau dengar-dengar.
Kadang-kadang macam terdengar. Tapi kadang kita terdengar pun macam kita try to be rational lah.
Husnuzon.
Kita husnuzon lah.
Tapi guys, ada lagi satu benda seram. Tapi dia bukan pasal bahasa pengalaman ataupun macam apa ni, benda-benda yang kau dengar yang seram.
Okay.
Aku nak tanya korang pasal satu benda seram. Aku tak tahu whether korang pernah kena ke tidak.
Okay.
Aku tanya dulu. Okay. Tapi kita akan sambung dalam next episode.
Okay.
So dia soalan lah sebenarnya yang seram. Okay. So aku don't know whether korang pernah dengar ke tidak. So soalan dia macam ni.
Okay.
Semua orang buat podcast, korang pun nak buat podcast. Pernah kena?
Of course lah.
Of course.
Okay, kita akan cerita dengan diorang sebentar saja nanti. Tapi sebelum tu kita dengar daripada penaja-penaja Ace Realtors yang boleh dikatakan seram jugalah yang kita berbual dengan diorang. Let's go. You and now listening to Sembang Alright guys, so sekarang ni kita bersama dengan teman-teman kami daripada Ace Realtors SG. Specifically, kita ada hari ni dua ejen yang comel loteh. Kita ada Bob Sofian, OK Pasti OK, dan juga kita ada ejen Shwandi.
Yo.
Ejen yo tak apa, ejennya yo jangan. Ni sekarang ni cakap pasal ejen yo ni. Aku ada soalan jugalah nak tanya. Okay, pasal kita banyak kali kita dengar macam orang selalu cakap pilih ejen yang betul-betul, pilih ejen yang betul-betul. But apa tu ejen yang betul-betul? Ada ke ejen yang tak betul? Pernah ada terjadi ke? What are some of the things that kita sebagai buyer ataupun seller nak engage agent ni, kita nak kena look out. Ada red flag, macam red flag.
Kena tinggi ke, kena pendek ke?
Kau pilih agent ke, pilih jodoh?
Itu pilih terus, let's go. Dia kata settlekan rumah sekali.
Kau dah pilih lain.
Itu dia apply BTO dengan kau. Ada tak? Sorry guys.
Okay.
Red flags lah.
Red flag
okay, lah. Okay. If you here recent cases about rental cases especially.
Okay.
Ada tenants yang kena transfer duit to agent dahulu. Sebelum I grant you viewings.
Okay.
That is actually red tip.
Red flag.
The reason is because kita cannot hold transactional money.
Oh, is it?
Okay, kalau I want to do rental for you, I can bring you in for viewings, but the money has to be given to the landlord.
Correct.
Jadi bila this is a scam tau. This is really happening. And diorang, this so-called claim agent, dia cakap, okay, transfer the money to me and then I grant you viewing. Itu
sekejap. Aku dengar macam ada dampir dia.
I'm bleeding into the...
Tepi sikit. Mungkin. Aku tak tahu. Kena. Oh, betul.
Sorry.
Dia penat lah.
Nak jawab juga.
Okay.
Ni sambung.
Okay.
So I mean, basically, whenever you want to do a viewing, you will never have to pay first, what?
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Betul.
So when they ask you to pay first, that's a bit funny. So that was also happening when rental was quite macam susah dapat.
Okay.
High demand. So these tenants are desperate. So when they kena macam ini, they think that okay, I pay then most likely I secure.
Yeah.
So obviously not lah, because at the end of the day, kita as agent, we are not supposed to hold any money.
Even if it's a bit.
Yeah,
correct.
Oh. That scam agent managed to take away 1 million plus.
Seriously?
Bukan 2,000-3,000.
That means several units ni.
Ni multiple many, units. Many
no, but one unit more than one viewings mah.
Yalah. Yeah.
So example, I want to rent this house at 5,000.
Okay.
So four of you want to view, right? So 5,000, 5,000, 5,000.
Then
already 20,000.
Yeah.
Habis
dia banyak.
Habis berapa banyak
sih
orang nak tengok.
Oh sabar, dia punya viewing bukan pasal 200 untuk view. Dia pasal that amount yang dia nak.
So this is what has been done. It has been published on paper. Sampaikan we are on high alert lah. Sampai macam okay agents go and take note. Jangan sampai you fall into such scams or don't do or keep a lookout on your own identity and stuff. Sampai macam gitu.
Kau sampai 1 million dah tak kelakar je. Bakal ramai.
Dah kena tangkap?
I didn't follow up on the case lah, but I know he was alerted to all rental agents.
Okay, itu kalau kita mention pasal rental punya agent that got viral lah. Ni aku nak tanya, I don't know whether it's a scam ke, I don't know whether it's unethical practice ke, but I just want to ask, there were some agents that charge untuk viewing. Kira macam diorang punya fees lah. Pasal bila korang give viewing, I don't know about you guys, but there are some agents that akan pick you up from your house.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Drive you to different multiple locations for viewings lah.
And then they charge.
I don't know.
Ada ke ni?
Macam service fee lah.
Dengarnya ada.
Okay.
Kononnya dia punya customer service fee lah. Kira correct. Bawa aku
kalau
pergi.
Kalau aku suruh dia naik Grab fee sudahlah. Pergi bayar Grab.
Rasa dia macam gitulah.
Betul lah kan?
Tapi I think that is again not normal lah. But because especially let's say you seller agent, right? So you to do that is charging money is a bit weird. Tapi kalau kita as buyer agent, at the same time kita akan bawa kita pay buyer lah together. But we don't charge them. We still charge them based on our commission, based on transaction close lah. Yeah, but if you to charge them to bring them around or even to presentation, kita belum tahap doktor lagi lah. doktor jumpa dah kena bayar kan. Kita belum lagi lah.
So far, we at Ace, kita cakap macam ni. Okay, maybe to fetch you from your house, tinggal Jurong, nak tengok Tampines, maybe tak masuk akal lah. Tapi kalau cakap, okay, let's meet at the first house, and then our viewings are all in Tampines and Pasir Ris, okay, I bring you around. If you don't have transport.
Because along the way
along
lah kan.
Along the way lah kan. Kalau lepas tu dia cakap, Bob, aku ingat, kau where's your next appointment? Okay, my appointment at say Clementi. Okay, I drop you off nanti Clementi, kau balik lah. Okay lah, reasonable right?
Okay. So that untuk sebagai housing agent, there is no fixed punya cara. Pasal kalau viewing, memang agent nak kena bawa one by one.
This all like goodwill lah.
Goodwill.
Okay. So for those yang charge tu actually tak salah lah.
I mean if you tapi tak betul lah.
Masing-masing lah.
Dia part time grab. Kau kena faham.
Okay, mungkin lah. Agent hustling.
Macam
hustling.
Kau dulu yang Sentosa, bila kau kerja Sentosa. Kau tak nak diorang jalan jauh-jauh. Kau kasih demi tiket kat situ je.
Betul, customer service fee.
Kau janganlah bilang tu under table suar.
Kerja dah habis pun.
Okay. These two things, ada tak any other more red flags yang kita as customer nak engage agent nak kena look out for?
Okay, so primarily it's mainly money lah. Kalau cakap in terms of your personal details, that is of course nak kena kasi your agent, pasal he will be filling up the form for you and all kan.
Correct.
So ada sampai buyer takut nak kasi kita details. Nama tak nak kasi, IC tak nak kasi. Tapi macam mana kita nak transact kan? So itu bukan red flag. Itu stupid flag lah. You want to know.
Stupid flag.
So if you want to know, very very simple. Rule of thumb, when it comes to money, agent will not hold any in terms of the transactional money. Option fee ke, exercise fee
any
ke.
Any checks ke, apa ke.
Checks. Okay, checks kita boleh pegang.
That's the part.
Okay. I cannot open my check for you.
Okay,
let's say you don't have check ah. Okay, Bob, aku nak down payment ni
RM50,000.
I cannot extend, Bob. On your mind, I use my check for you.
Okay.
You transfer to me. Tak boleh. So you have to go to the bank.
Get
buka
check.
A cashier's order. Then I can hold the check and pass it for you.
Okay.
Okay.
So I mean, overall meaning anything to do with the transaction, in terms of money, kita tak boleh pegang. So macam even physical cash, kerana we want to deposit the first 1,000 yang ada kasih physical cash kan. So we ask the buyer to give physically to the seller.
So
we cannot like hold and we give lah.
Okay.
Cerita ni bermula pasal dulu-dulu tau. Agent-agent dulu suruh ambil ni duit, suruh lari. Jadi macam yeah, why put then agent into a temptation situation?
Okay.
So rather than that, so the government or the authority decided, okay, agent, to control your temptations, you don't hold any money. Kalau tidak, makin banyak buat gini, kadang-kadang yalah, on some good days we may be transacting like 3-4 rumah satu hari. So example, kalau kita buat satu 1% $50,000, so kalau ada 4 rumah kita buat macam ni, I be holding 200,000 going round tau.
Ya, yeah, betul.
Orang boleh rompak apa-apa. The temptation for me to run, alamak, kalau kau ambil duit ni aku pergi round the world tour ke apa, sedap kan. This is our temptation, right? So this is something that they try to deter lah.
So at the same time, that's where also they came up with the CEA. CEA macam agents need to go through the course, take exam.
Governing board.
CEA tu apa?
Something agents.
Council for estate agents.
Okay.
So basically, dulu datuk nenek nyonya mana pun boleh jadi agent. So then because you last time there's no authority to say you can be agent. So you can, anybody can just sign up be agent. So that's why when they came up with this, so it become more professional lah. So with the, you go to the course to the this. So that's where it become more professional punya.
Oh tu yang datangnya course, lepas tu sekarang ada exam, ERS and all this lah.
So that way you also minus all this other funny people.
Okay.
So the people who really goes into this business, the proper business lah.
Bad apples are everywhere lah. You cannot remove them out of any industry because typically it boils down to human. Betul lah?
Yeah.
Okay.
So what the authority do is to stringent the process of becoming a real estate agent.
Okay.
Then I will be able to filter the pool that are coming in are better group of people. They are better educated. They dorang are not gonna have a history of bankrupt. Dorang tak pernah ada issue of breach of trust in terms of money.
Okay.
Then you qualify for all this.
Okay, Bob. Tadi Bob pun ada mention pasal you guys not allowed to hold money, transactional money. But the things that you might you might be asking for ataupun the customer should be giving you macam personal details untuk korang submit apa-apa. Like what are some of the personal details yang macam when it comes to you signing ataupun nak tolong customer, what are some personal details that you will be definitely asking for? Jadi bila orang nak beli ni, kali Bob minta IC, kali maybe Shwandi minta CPF punya statement. Dah orang terkejut pula. Jadi kita pre-empt dia orang.
So basically now digital world, the one thing SingPass. So SingPass can go through all this. So normally I think for younger ones 30 plus 40 plus, okay. Cuma yang orang tua, so tu yang susah sikit. So nak kena tanya, cik ada SingPass ke tak? Kalau tak ada, then maybe can ask the kids to help them to sign up SingPass and everything. Because through the SingPass, that's where we can access the HDB, CPF and everything. Then we can advise better.
Gateway, senang cakap, the gateway to your financial records.
Yelah, dulu kena tulis-tulis form, lambat-lambat, fill up.
Login individually.
Sekarang dah tak ada.
Sekarang
semua SingPass.
Yeah.
So if you have your SingPass app in your phone,
easy, okay?
So all you need to do is to scan my phone when I flash you the QR. Then I will be able to retrieve what is the necessary information from you.
Only the necessary, right? The rest tak
perlu lah. Kalau orang dulu-dulu, diorang selalu cakap apa tau, tak boleh lah, I cannot give you your SingPass, nanti you will transfer the money. Sebenarnya ni benda tak pernah wujud pun. Kita tak boleh just go in random. Okay, hari ni aku nak kasih Ana RM50,000, nak kasih this RM50,000. This thing doesn't exist sebenarnya.
Daripada SingPass
Daripada SingPass.
Dia bukan bank app tau, dia SingPass.
Dia ingat SingPass.
Dia orang confused.
Okay.
Another one yang diorang selalu kita minta lah, the common ones are IC, your marriage cert, then your birth cert, and then your HFE, which is your loan eligibility letters, kan?
Yeah.
Okay.
All this is to help us bila kita nak buat submission. Mm-hmm. These are the common documents that they require. Uh-huh. The HDB mm-hmm. ataupun maybe sometimes the lawyer mm-hmm. will want to know, okay, are they legitimate? Mm-hmm. Kalau out of web, macam mana nak minta and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So these are the common documents that they require lah.
Alright, alright. So tadi macam kita mention, SingPass nombor satu, HFE, birth cert,
merit cert.
Yeah. So these are the few things lah yang definitely agent akan minta lah. Alright. Okay guys, so korang dah dengar daripada apa ni, Agent Shwandi dan juga Agent Bob. So jangan terkejut kalau seandainya agent minta those few documents. Yeah. Yang penting always remember, kalau diorang minta duit, itu yang baru korang nak kena 50-50 sikit lah. Jadi jangan lupa, kalau korang need more information, korang boleh lah check out kita punya kawan-kawan daripada Ace Realtors SG. Untuk masyarakat, demi masyarakat.
Jangan lupa untuk follow rakan-rakan kami di Instagram dan juga TikTok, isrealtors.sg.
Kalau korang nak beli rumah ke, nak jual rumah ke, tak payah pening-pening kepala, korang boleh hubungi ejen-ejen bertaliah daripada isrealtors.sg.
Korang juga boleh terus hubungi mereka di talian 8877-9923. 8877-9923. Bok-bok muka senyum. Cik apa ni? Okay guys, kita akan jumpa korang di episod seterusnya.
Sembang Panas.
Betul, tak ada soro-soro, ini bukan cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro, ini bukan cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro, ini bukan cakap betul. Tak ada soro-soro. Siapa-siapa boleh go, semua kita undang. Siapa berani masuk, jangan sebab terberang. Alkisah bikin panas macam goreng pisang, itu sudah terang. Panggil semua geng-geng minat turun, jom masuk gelanggang. Jom masuk studio, dah berapa banyak idol. Kita kasih sampai viral, Alkisah dapat title. Ini Sembang Panas, it's love for the week. Ini Sembang Panas, real love on the mix, boom. Sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas. Sembang, sembang panas, 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 panas.